ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், லெட் மீ கண்டினியூ வித் எக்ஸசைஸ் 8.4 ஃபிஃப்த் ரோமன் நம்பர் சிக்ஸ்த் சம். யூ ஹாவ் டு ப்ரூவ் ஒன் பிளஸ் சைன் ஏ பாய் ஒன் மைனஸ் சைன் ஏ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சீக்கண்ட் ஏ பிளஸ் டான் ஏ. So here you have to prove LHS is equal to RHS. Let me take the LHS, that is square root of 1 plus sin A by 1 minus sin A. Remember, whenever trigonometric ratios are given within the square root, you multiply and divide by the conjugate of the denominator. What is the denominator here? 1 minus sin A. What is its conjugate? It is 1 plus sin A. So I am going to multiply and divide by its conjugate within the square root. So 1 plus sin A by 1 minus sin A. Into what is the conjugate of 1 minus sin A? It is 1 plus sin A. So I am multiplying, dividing by the conjugate. So that the value will not change. So it is square root of, in the numerator you have 1 plus sin A into 1 plus sin A. 1 plus sin A into 1 plus sin A can be written as 1 plus sin A the whole squared by what is in the denominator? 1 minus sin A into 1 plus sin A. It is in the form of A minus B into A plus B. That can be written as A squared minus b squared. So it is square root of 1 plus sin a the whole squared by, you know the identity, sin squared a plus cos squared a is equal to 1. From that, cos squared a is equal to 1 minus sin squared a. So in the place of 1 minus sin squared a in the denominator, I am going to replace with cos squared a. So it is 1 by square root of 1 plus sin a the whole squared by cos squared a. That is square root of 1 plus sin a the whole squared by cos squared a can be written as cos a the whole squared. Since both the numerator and denominator is within the row square, both can be written with the whole square. That is 1 plus sin a by cos a the whole squared. That is a squared by b squared can be written as a by b the whole squared. Same format. Now square root of a square number, the square gets cancelled. So you get 1 plus sin a by cos a. So what do you get here? 1 plus sin a by cos a. So that can be written as 1 by cos a plus sin a by cos a. What is 1 by cos a? That is nothing but secant a plus, what is sin a by cos a? That is nothing but tan a. So that is what your RHS. So what we do here, whenever you get the trigonometric ratio in the square root, you multiply and divide by the conjugate and have the square as it is and apply the identity and do. So we have proved LHS is equal to RHS. Hope it's clear, children. You should be thorough with the identities while doing these problems. Now let me teach you the next sum, that is seventh one, sin theta minus 2 sin cube theta by 2 cos cube theta minus cos theta is equal to tan theta. Let me take the LHS, sin theta minus 2 sin cube theta by 2 cos cube theta minus cos theta. In the numerator, sin theta is common. So I take sin theta outside. So sin theta into 1 minus 2. In sin cube, 1 sin theta I have taken outside. So sin square theta will be there. By cos theta is common in the denominator. So if I take cos theta, 2 in cos cube theta, 1 cos theta we have taken common. So you get 2 cos square theta minus 1. So that is equal to sin theta into 1. Minus 2 sin square theta, I am going to write it as minus sin square theta minus sin square theta. Because you know minus sin square theta minus sin square theta is nothing but minus 2 sin square theta. By cos theta into, again 2 cos square theta can be written as cos square theta plus cos square theta. Because cos square theta plus cos square theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. That is equal to sin theta into, you should know the identity. You know the identity sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So from this, cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Also cos square theta minus 1 is equal to minus sin square theta. So in the numerator, in the place of 1 minus sin square theta, I am going to replace with cos square theta. So cos square theta minus sin square theta by cos theta into cos square theta, and cos square theta minus 1 here I am going to replace with minus sin square theta. So it is sin theta into cos square theta minus sin square theta by cos theta into cos square theta minus sin square theta. Since the numerator and denominator have the same value, I cancel that. So I get sin theta by cos theta, that is nothing but tan theta, that is nothing but your RHS. So we have proved the LHS is equal to RHS. Is it clear, children? Next we will move on to the next problem, that is 8th sum, that is sin A plus cosecant A the whole square plus cos A plus secant A the whole square is equal to 7 plus tan squared A plus cot squared A. Okay, so what is your LHS? Sin A plus cosecant A the whole square plus cos A plus secant A the whole square. So it is in the form of A plus B the whole square. A plus B the whole square is nothing but A square plus 2AB plus B square. So sin A the whole square is sin squared A plus 2AB, 2 into sin A into cosecant A 2AB plus B squared is cosecant squared A plus cos A plus secant A the whole square. Again it can be written in the form of A squared. So A squared plus 2AB plus 2 into cos A into secant A plus B squared, that is secant squared A. We want the answer in the form of 7 plus tan squared A plus cot squared A. And you know sin squared A plus cos squared A, if I add I get 1, that is one of the identity. Plus, and you know sin A and cosecant A, sin squared A plus cos squared A is equal to 1, that is one of the identity. And you know sin A and cosecant A are reciprocal of each other. So if you multiply them you always get 1. Similarly, cos A and secant A are reciprocal of each other. If you multiply that you get 1. And cosecant squared A is nothing but 1 plus cot squared A, that is again one of the identity. Similarly, secant squared A is 1 plus tan squared A. So we are going to use all these identities in this problem. That is sin squared A plus cos squared A is equal to 1, cosecant squared A equal to 1 plus cot squared A, secant squared A is equal to 1 plus tan squared A. And you know sin and cosecant are reciprocal of each other, so if you multiply them you get 1. Similarly, cos A and secant are reciprocal of each other, if you multiply them you get 1. So sin squared A plus cos squared A I replace with 1 plus 2 into sin A into cosecant A is nothing but 1 because they are reciprocal of each other, plus cos squared A I replace with 1 plus cot squared A plus 2 into cos A into secant A are reciprocal of each other, so when I multiply that I get 1 plus secant squared A can be written as 1 plus tan squared A. So it is equal to 1 plus 2 1s are 2 plus 1 plus cot squared A plus 2 1s are 2 plus 1 plus tan squared A. Now add all the numerals, 1 plus 2 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus 2 6, 6 plus 1 7 plus cot squared A plus tan squared A. So we have proved that sin A plus cosecant A the whole square plus cos A plus secant A the whole square is equal to 7 plus cot squared A plus tan squared A. That is LHS is equal to RHS. So these are the three basic identities. Using that we can do these type of problems. Hope it's clear, children. Now we'll move on to the next problem, that is cosecant A minus sin A into secant A minus cos A is equal to 1 by tan A plus cot A. So let me take the LHS. Cosecant A minus sin A into secant A minus cos A. See, the answer should be in the form of tan and cot, or you know cosecant can be written as 1 by sin because it is the reciprocal of sin. So cosecant is 1 by sin A minus sin A into secant A is 1 by cos A minus cos A. Now take the LCM for the first term. So sin A is LCM. So 1 minus sin squared A by sin A into what is LCM for this? Cos A. So 1 minus cos squared A. You know sin squared A plus cos squared A is equal to 1. From this I can write sin squared A is equal to 1 minus cos squared A. Similarly, cos squared A can be written as 1 minus sin squared A. So here the numerator 1 minus sin squared A I am going to replace with cos squared A. So cos squared A by sin A into 1 minus cos squared A I am going to replace with sin squared A into sin squared A by cos A. This sin A in the denominator and 1 sin A in the numerator gets cancelled, and 1 cos A in the denominator and 1 cos A in the numerator gets cancelled. So I get cos A into sin A. Let me have the LHS as it is because I am not getting in terms of tan and cot. Now I am going to take RHS and prove LHS and RHS separately. I prove and say they are equal. So what is RHS? 1 by tan A plus cot A. LHS is in the form of cos and sin. So I am going to write tan in terms of sin and cos and cot in terms of sin and tan. So what is tan? Sin by cos. So tan A can be written as sin A by cos A plus cot A can be written as cos A by sin A. So that is equal to 1 by, take the LCM for the denominator, it is cos A sin A. So what do you get here? Sin squared A plus cos squared A. That is equal to 1 by, what is sin squared A plus cos squared A? That is equal to 1. So 1 by cos A sin A. So you know it is 1 into reciprocal of the denominator. Since it is division, reciprocal of the denominator. So it is cos A by sin, cos A into sin A by 1. So it is cos A sin A. So LHS is also cos A sin A. RHS is also cos A sin A. So we have proved LHS is equal to RHS. Are you clear, children? Let me teach you the last sum of this exercise. That is 1 plus tan squared A by 1 plus cot squared A is equal to 1 minus tan A by 1 minus cot A the whole square. That is equal to tan squared A. Normally LHS will be equal to RHS. That is how you prove. But here the three parts should be equal. Three things should be proved equal. So I take this as first and this is second and this is third. So if I prove 1 equal to 3 and 2 equal to 3, then all the 3 will become equal. So I am going to take the first thing, that is 1 plus tan squared A by 1 plus cot squared A. You know 1 plus tan squared A is nothing but secant squared A as per the identity. By 1 plus cot squared A is nothing but cosecant squared A. And you know secant squared can be written as 1 by cos squared A. Because we want the answer as tan squared A. By what is cosecant squared A? You can write it as 1 by sin squared A. So a fraction divided by another fraction, the first fraction remains the same, multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction. So sin squared A by 1. 1 into sin squared A is sin squared A. By cos squared A into 1 is cos squared A. What is cos sin squared A by cos squared A? That is nothing but tan squared A. This is the third part. So we have proved 1 is equal to 3. We have proved 1 is equal to 3. Now I am going to prove 2 also is equal to 3. What is the second part? 1 minus tan A by 1 minus cot A the whole square. So 1 minus tan A by 1 minus cot can be written as 1 by tan because it's a reciprocal of tan. So it is 1 minus tan A by what is LCM for the denominator? Tan A. So tan A minus 1 by tan A the whole square. So it is equal to 1 minus tan A multiplied by the reciprocal of the denominator. So tan A by tan A minus 1 the whole square. So numerator remains the same, multiplied by the reciprocal of the denominator is tan A by tan A minus 1 the whole square. So it is 1 minus tan A into tan A by tan A minus 1. I am going to write it as minus 1 into 1 minus tan A. Tan A minus 1, I am going to write it as minus 1 into 1 minus tan A. Anyway, minus 1 into 1 is minus 1. Minus 1 into minus tan A is plus tan A. Right. So, Now 1 minus tan A, 1 minus tan A in the numerator and denominator gets cancelled. So what do you have here? Tan A by minus 1 the whole squared. What is tan A by minus 1? It is minus tan A the whole squared. That is nothing but plus tan squared A. So this is nothing but third part. So we have proved second part is also equal to third part. So first is equal to third and second equal to third, which implies 1, 2, 3, all the 3 are equal. So we have proved 1 plus tan squared A by 1 plus cot squared A is equal to 1 minus tan A by 1 minus cot A the whole squared, that is equal to tan squared A. Hope it's clear, children. Thank you.